محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ثم ما بعد الإمام النووي رحمه الله تعالى في كتاب الدعوات من رياض الصالحين The Book of Supplication قال وعن أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه أنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم In this hadith, hadith number 1475, he reported Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله تعالى عنه وارضاه He approached the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم And he said to him, قال لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم علمني دعاء أدعو به في صلاتي He said, O Messenger of Allah, teach me. He said, teach me a dua, a supplication, which I can recite in my salah. Teach me a dua, a supplication that I can recite in my salah. قال, so the Prophet ﷺ answered him, said, قل, اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت فاغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني innaka Antal-Ghafur-ur-Rahim muttafaqun alayh so the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he taught him to say the following dua Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi zulman kathiran oh allah I have considerably wronged myself like I've been so extravagant against my own self wala yaghfirudh dhunuba illa ant and I know that there is none to forgive these sins but you faghfir li maghfiratan min indik ya allah So grant me pardon and forgiveness min indik warhamni and have mercy on me. Innaka Antal-Ghafur-ur-Rahim, you are the most forgiving and the most compassionate. Rawah Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Let's try to study this dua, Jama'ah. So beautiful, subhanAllah. And what is more beautiful is this dua is coming from whom? Who is asking for this dua? Do you know, Jama'ah, who was asking the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Do you know who Abu Bakr Siddiq was? The closest man to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one whose iman cannot match, you can't match his iman in the community in that time with anybody. Like this man was way up there. To the extent that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, he ordered all the doors that were leading to the masjid because people they had doors through the walls of the masjid. He said, close these doors, all these doors except for Abu Bakr Siddiq. When the Prophet ﷺ was in the last of his days of his life, he was mentioning the favors of the people. He goes, everybody in this community, I have a favor upon them. I have a favor on them. Except Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He has the favor upon me. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he would say, Astaghfirullah ya Rasulullah. Absolutely not. He would deny that. But the Prophet acknowledged that. Because he's the only one who took me, you know, sheltered me, he gave me his daughter for marriage, he supported me, he protected me, he sacrificed his life. He put his life and the life of his family in danger the time of the hijrah. And he was the man to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that is a man that Allah guaranteed Jannah, Jama'ah. And still, he would not stop learning. And he would come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he would say, Ya Rasulullah, teach me. Teach me something I could say in my salah. Subhanallah. Never stop learning. And obviously, because he has this close relationship with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he wanted something private. He said, Ya Rasulullah, teach me something special that I can truly say in my salah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told him dua that is unbelievable. I mean, this dua you could say, if anyone not supposed to make this dua, probably would be Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Because he's a man, mashallah, in terms of his iman, he's up to that level. Yani Allah hopefully forgave all his mistakes and errors and so on. So why would he be asking for forgiveness or committing or admitting his faults and so on? Still though, the Prophet ﷺ teaching us humbleness through that dua. Like even someone like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq still need to ask Allah for forgiveness. Even someone like Muhammad ﷺ, he used to say, Astaghfirullah, seek forgiveness from Allah because I seek forgiveness from him more than 100 times, 70 times a day. And that's the Messenger of Allah. So he taught him that dua. So never ever stop learning. And never ever think that, you know what, there's a time when that's it. My learning opportunity is gone. Ever. So the Prophet taught him this dua. قُلْ اللَّهُمَّ إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ ظُلْمًا إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ نَفْسِي ظُلْمًا كَثِيرًا He said, say, Ya Allah, I have wronged myself considerably. So much. I've been so extravagant in the way I've wronged myself. ظُلْمًا كَثِيرًا And look at this, subhanAllah. He did not attribute his sins to Allah Azza wa Jal, to himself. He did not attribute that, and he called his own wrongdoing zulm, injustice. But he didn't attribute that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Instead, he says, my Lord, I'm committing so much injustice against my own self. So he attributed it to himself, out of adab ma Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, this part of the dua is admitting his weakness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember Sheikh Omar, yesterday when we talked about the dua and the etiquette of the dua, and he said, look at dua of Zakaria, which we subhanAllah, we had the khatra for it in the weekend. The dua of Zakaria, he was admitting his brokenness. He was admitting his fault, his weakness. My Lord, I'm getting old. I'm becoming frail. My bones are so soft and fragile. And then he asked Allah for help and assistance. Here, same thing. My Lord, I've wronged so much. I'm weak. I can't stand against my own desires. I'm so, unfortunately, not so strong in front of these temptations. So he is admitting at this weakness. And then he says, وَلَا يَغْفِرُ الدُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. And I know no one forgives these sins but you. I came to you. Ya Allah. I'm admitting my fault. I'm so broken. And I know no one can fix it but you. Then he says, faghfir li. So forgive me. Ya Allah, forgive me. Maghfiratan min indik. I want forgiveness from you. What does it mean when he says forgiveness from you? Maghfiratan min indik. Like he's saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though I don't deserve it. Like I didn't do anything to deserve maghfirah, probably. But I just want this from you. Like I know my level of good deeds are not at the level where I can say, you owe me, astaghfirullah. Never. So he said, not because I've done anything that I can say I'm proud of it to seek to take that forgiveness, but just because I depend on you because I know no one can forgive but you. So Ya Allah, forgive me. فَغْفِرْ مَغْفِرَةَ مِنْ عِنْدِكَ وَارْحَمْنِي. And have mercy on me. Maghfira and mercy. Maghfira for the past and mercy for the future. Forgive me what I've done in the past and have mercy on me to protect me not to do it again in the future. إِنَّكَ Antal-Ghafur-ur-Rahim. Because I know you are the one who oft forgiving and you are the one who is most merciful. Look at this beautiful dua. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told him to say it in his salah. Because he asked, Ya Rasulullah, help me learn the dua I can say in my salah. And he taught him this dua. So this dua can be said in your sujood. Can be said after your tashahud. You can say the dua after salah and before salah. Anytime. This dua is a general dua. And as you can see, Jawami' al-Kalim, the beautiful collection of the meanings in few words from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There was another narration of the Prophet that Abu Bakr As-Siddiq, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, help me learn dua that I can say fi salati wa fi bayti, at home and in my salah. So make sure even when you are at home, keep repeating that dua as well too, inshallah ta'ala. So let's repeat this dua together, inshallah azza wa jal. Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi zulman kathiran wa la yaghfiru dhunub إلا أنت فاغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت فاغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت فاغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم اللهم آمين. Any question يا جماعة؟ Bismillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us this maghfirah and rahmah ya rabbil alameen. Fadha. So So the question about the doors that I referred to when the Prophet ordered all the doors to be closed. What are the meaning of these doors? So back in those days, the way they build their houses, the masjid was in the center, and people, they build their houses around. Whoever is closest will have like a prime location out of the masjid. They have a door that leads to the masjid from their house. Subhanallah. So this is how privileged they were. Before the Prophet ﷺ passed away, he says, all these doors should be closed. Illa khawqat Abi Bakr. Permanently to be closed, except for the door of Bakr as-Siddiq. Obviously, the public doors were still open, but the private ones to be closed except for the door of Bakr as-Siddiq. If you go to Medina today, one of the doors in the old structure of Masjid Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is named what? Babu Abi Bakr. And inside, if you ever go inside, there is somewhere where it says Khawqatu Abi Bakr. Which is basically the Khawqa means basically the opening. Not necessarily the door, it's just like more like an opening. So he had his own privileged space to come in and out. And some of the ulama, they say that was like a subtle message from the Prophet ﷺ to the Ummah. Like, listen, I'm giving him this privilege. Like, I want him to be in my place. Because the Prophet had his door open as well to the masjid, right? He goes, close all the other doors except for his. So that was the subtle message to the people to choose Abu Bakr as-Siddiq after him, which they did, radiallahu ta'ala anhum warḍahum. Wallahu ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair. Inshallah ta'ala, right now, if you guys, inshallah, have a few minutes, bin Allah Azza wa Jal, would like to share our condolences with brother Zubair and his family, inshallah ta'ala. So it's going to be in the multi-purpose hall. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.